Schenkels e Hans Pils dal comune di Utrecht per parlarci del, in particolare del progetto Food for Good che si sta svolgendo in quella città.
Yes, you have to put on the presentation. But I introduce myself. I'm Jeroen Schenkels from the municipality of Utrecht. And this is Hans Pels. He is introducing himself later. We are doing this together. So he's from the initiative Food for Good, food initiative in Utrecht. And I'm talking, we are all, presenting an example for a very practical example for cooperation between the municipality and an initiative about out of the community. So, I'm a program manager for the green structure planning, so it's something different, and also policy making for environmental issues in the development part department in Utrecht. And Utrecht is a big city, the fourth big city in the Netherlands, in the center of the country. We have 330,000 inhabitants. And in an area with 2 million inhabitants, and it's a growing city. Yes, we are doubled in the last 20 years, and now we are growing between 2020 and 2030 to 400,000 people. So we have a big challenge in staying sustainable and healthy. And our ambition is to keep the people in our city, of course, and give work to them. So we want to let them work and live in the city and stay there. So we want to attract a city, and our challenge is how do we do that? So we want to be healthy and sustainable. You know, that's our ambition. So local food plays, in our view, a distinctive role in the ambition of Utrecht to build this healthy future. Indeed, local food is a production. Can have a significant beneficial social effects, such as reducing social isolation and tackle problems like obesity. So we think that's we have a focus on health. So, and of course, there are other benefits of a good food system, so like CO2, for instance. But in our council, they focus on health. But it's not just the city council, of course, that's aware of this social effects. Of course, there are inhabitants who have a lot of ideas about a sustainable food system and have all kinds of food initiatives. And urban agriculture, for instance, is blossoming in our town. And we say shooting out of the ground like mushrooms. That's a Dutch term for it. And the goodest example is Food for Good, of course. Not only our restaurant entrepreneurs serving more and more local food, but also our university, where we have the biggest of the Netherlands, have 200 researchers on future food projects, and that's they are busy with how to feed food the planet in a sustainable and healthy way. So there are a lot of activities, and we of course give extra impulses to facilitate people initiatives and with space and sometimes money or opportunities to meet each other and to learn from each other. So we networking and. We're networking with local groups, but also we have a city network.
Good team.
and we are a team in town. So all of these actions together, we have a food strategy, and that food strategy we developing the next years, and we are involved in the Food Smart Cities project. Therefore, also to get ideas and to give ideas, so to share experience with other cities of Europe and the world. So this is nice blah blah blah, and now we are going to Hans Pels, who gives more practical and experience about his project, and he's changing.
Changing chairs. Thank you, Jeroen.
Shall I put you out?
Yes. My name is Hans Pels, and I'm from a foundation, a private foundation. We are like a social enterprise, and we create social garden projects. All over the Netherlands, we are busy with using nature and food and playing outside as a means for the well-being of people. And one of the projects is Food for Good. And Food for Good is in Utrecht. It's a garden. We call it the food garden for everyone with or without green fingers. So everyone is welcome. Here you see a picture from the sky, and you see the park. On the right side, you see a little bed. So that's the garden. So it's a small part in a park. Maybe you can show you. Yeah. So that's the garden, and it's one of the areas of the town which is not so well known. There's a lot of unemployment. It's one of the unhealthiest areas in town. They estimate that people live there 2 years less than in the rest of the town. So it's really a lot of things going on. So it's really interesting place to create a social garden. There are a lot of elderly people living there, on the left. And on the right, there is very old industry, and that's now transforming in new creative industries and new houses. And also students are coming, so it's really a place in transition. And the food, the garden, is a way to integrate all these new developments. And this picture explains how the garden works. On the right, you see a woman. She is 62 years old. She's unemployed. And then you get a boy. He has an autistic background, so he really needs structure and focus and not too big tasks. And then you got another guy. He is mentally disabled. He comes from North Africa. And a child. And this is how the garden works. The lady is 62 years old. She has she's the guidance. She makes the plan. So today we are going to plant salad, and it has to be so much meters and so on. So she explains it, and then the guy he does the work. You know, very close to the ground, he measures it exactly and plants the salad. And then the mentally disabled guy, the only thing he does is water the plants. He comes only to the garden, and he only waters plants. Even if it's raining, he always the same job. But this time, it's really helpful that he's watering the plants. And then this kid is the son of one of the other volunteers who likes to help. And now he's helping watering the plants. So this is how the social structure works. And food is the connecting. Working with food is the connecting part. And also for elderly people, this lady, she's 79 years old, from an Indonesian background. Oh, that's too quick. And she had her own garden, but she's not fit enough to work in her own garden. So she comes to our garden, so she can still work with food and be with people. And the lady with the caps, that's the coordinator. There's one lady, she's the gardener, and she makes the plans, and she explains what to do. And so a lot of people work together. And the most special thing about the garden is, and that's also what people are telling us, the most special thing about this garden is that I meet people which I would normally never meet. When you have with your friends or with your family or at your club, you meet only people you know. And here you meet people which you on street you would normally not talk to. Also for myself, it's really an experience for people from jail working with them. And it's really exciting to learn people. You don't have to talk about it. You're just working together in the garden. And it is in this part of town, there's a lot of people from Moroccan background. And they also come to the garden and they add values from their countries with several herbs and ways of producing stuff. So we learn from each other how we can grow food. And also very special for elderly people, especially for elderly people with health problems. So some of them are grown up with growing food, and when their head is not working anymore, but their hands are still working. So when they feel soil, they just start to work, or they pick flowers. And it really helps them to feel their senses and to feel that they're more in the present. And then they start talking about what they did in the youth. I start singing with each other. It's really the food and the green is really connecting people. And it's also good for other volunteers, but then they see these elderly people with all the strange things they say, and then when they get angry or mad or start to laugh. And so you get also more understanding how it is when people are getting health problems or memory problems. But the garden is also good for the government. This is two guys from the government. We made a deal with the government so that, because we took care of a piece of park, and then they help us with materials, but also with man hours. So these two guys, they helped us to make a pavement for the elderly people so that they can get in our cabin.
So Hans, how does the Utrecht help your push the goods more? Because it's nice. Pavements.
Yes, the municipality. Sometimes they say in initiatives which organize themselves without the municipality are the best initiatives. But I don't think so. So it's so good to work together because we have the same goals. The government has the same goal as we have, so we have to work together. So when this project started, we were working with an organization with people from the street, homeless people, and we're looking for a piece of land to start to work together. And the government helped us to find this piece of land, that's step one. And then we had to get the permission to use it, not only for a short time, but for a really long time, so we can build a really nice place. And the government arranged that. Then, of course, we need to know if the soil was good for growing food, and they tested the soil for us. And then all these things we had together, then we start to make a project plan, start to look for funding, and the government also helped in the funding with subsidy. So, and also what I said before, the sponsoring in materials and in hours. And we get a lot of political attention because the government is looking to be this facilitating government to give more freedom to initiatives, and they look from what do they like, and we get a lot of gratitude, or we get a lot of support. And last year, that's also new, because we also got for the first time money for all this social welfare. So people who are unemployed, we help them to get work experience, to give them structure, to get them out of the isolation. And we get money for that from the government. So we are building our business model with these kinds of things. And also, it's the best practice, so they really want to help us to grow. And now we get the opportunity to start a tea garden, like a small Horeca place. So we can work on a more stable financial income, because now we are dependent on social welfare money and from funding. Subsidies, and then we get also a commercial way of earning money, because selling food doesn't make any money. You cannot run a project on selling only vegetables. But when you process it into food or into gelées or compote or things like that, then you can make a living off it. So they will help us, and we get the opportunity to grow and to expand. So we get a lot of trust.
trust from civil servants, and civil servants also say, like, well, we want to work on the basis of trust. You don't have to make all kinds of reports and things like that. No, we trust that you are doing well, and we will support you. And that's really great to feel that you're not on the focus on the numbers, but that you feel you are doing this together. You're working on the same cause, and you're both working together and saying, well, we figure it out together. And that's really a nice atmosphere to work together. So by working together, for example, with Utrecht, we can create the mission of our foundation. So that's what it helps for us. So and how did we help? Who helped Utrecht?
Not only you help our goals for a healthy future, but also we have the slogan, we are making Utrecht together. So we do it with the civilians, and this is a great example for such a cooperation. It's co-creation of placemaking of new areas in this old district. And also very happy people, because you can't make mental this illness, you can't make someone not better, but he gets the meaning of life in this garden. So, and it's the same for elderly and so on. So everybody's happy when they're growing food, I think. And of course, in my work as green structure planner, you make 7,000 acres of land useful also for people and attractive, but also for the bees and the plants and animals there. So for the biodiversity is also a good example. Yeah, and you are a catalyst of the place, because he is linking his initiative to a tea garden, but also to a restaurant in the neighborhood. There's another restaurant coming in the neighborhood, and they are changing the food, so he's giving the vegetables, and he's giving the pizza oven, so it's good. And so you get interaction, and also with the elderly house, the home. That's very important for this neighborhood. It is giving activities there that you didn't get when you did do nothing, or you do it on the old way. So we are very, very, very glad with this kind of organic growing of the district. And it's the best practice for us. And I think you can copy it in other places. So it's a very worthy initiative to lean on. So, success with Food for Good.
So this is when we opened the garden last year. It's now we are busy now for 3.5 years. But last year we opened it, and then the mayor came, and we planted the mayor tree, and he planted it with us. He planted it together with volunteers. He had a really nice speech about cooperation, all the things that Jeroen is saying. But it's really working like that. And he also said, this is an apple tree, and especially apples for apple pie. And the Dutch make really good apple pie. So that when the first apples are harvested, hopefully next year, then he will get the first apple pie, and he's coming to get it on his bike, he promised us. So. So that's the example of working together. Yes. Thank you.